This is the next question we have. It says two solids dissociate as follows. A solid gives us B gas plus C gas. Equilibrium constant is mentioned. Then we have D solid gives us C gas plus E gas. Here also equilibrium constant is mentioned. The total pressure when both the solids dissociate simultaneously is, these are the four options we have. Let us assume the dissociation of A is taking place separately. In B gas and C gas. So at equilibrium, the pressures of B as well as C both will be same. Why? Because their coefficients are 1. I am talking about the stoichiometric coefficient, assuming we have started with A only. So let us assume its pressure is P1 at equilibrium. So the pressure of C will also be P1 at equilibrium. Now let's consider the second reaction. In the second reaction, we have D solid gives us C gas plus E gas. So let's write this, assuming it is taking place separately. So here we have D solid. This gives us C gas plus E gas. So at equilibrium, let's say its pressure is P2 and the pressure of E will also be P2 because their stoichiometric coefficients are 1. Now let's assume that these two reactions are taking place simultaneously. So C gas will be produced from here as well as here, that is from both the reactions. So the pressure for C gas in this reaction and in this reaction will be same because both reactions are taking place simultaneously. So the pressure here will be P1 plus P2 and here also P2 plus P1 or P1 plus P2. Now if I talk about the equilibrium constant in reaction 1, that is KP1. So KP1 will be equal to pressure of B into pressure of C. Pressure of B is given P1 and pressure of C is given P1 plus P2. And it is equals to x. Now if I talk about KP2, it will be partial pressure of C into partial pressure of E. So it is equals to P1 plus P2 into P2 and it is equals to y. Now if I divide these two equations, I will get P1 by P2 is equals to x by y. So from here I can have the value of P1. And the value of P1 will be equal to x by y times of P2. So we can put the value of P1 in equation 2, this one equation. So let's put the value. This implies x by y times of P2 plus P2 into P2 is equals to y. So from here I can write x plus y by y into P2 square is equals to y. So from here I can write the value of P2 square as y square by x plus y. Now if I calculate the value of P2, the value of P2 will be square root of this, that is y upon square root of x plus y. This is the value of P2. Now, as we know that P1 is equals to x by y times of P2. So, we can write that P1 is equals to x upon y into y by square root of x plus y. So, this gives us the result P1 is equals to x upon square root of x plus y. Now in the question it is given that find the total pressure. So what will be the total pressure? Let's find. I am talking about total pressure at equilibrium. So P total at equilibrium will be equal to pressure of B plus partial pressure of C plus partial pressure of E. Partial pressure of B is given P1. Partial pressure of C is given P1 plus P2. And partial pressure of E is P2. So it will be 2 times of P1 plus P2. Now let's put the value of P1 and P2. It is 2 into, the value of P1 is x upon square root of x plus y plus y upon square root of x plus y. Now if I solve this question or solve this equation, it will give us 2 times of square root of x plus y. So this will be the answer. Let's go through the options. If I go through the options, we can see here the correct answer is given in option 4. Hence, the correct answer for this question will be option 4. Now, let's move to the next question.